It is about the time that we take to discover new things. The time we need to breathe. Time for new experiences. And these experiences are what shape us. These experiences that we do not forget. Experiences from our shared adventures. So it is about the time to start a new adventure, because the world isn't flat, and that's what already the ancient Greeks knew. The Adventure Country Treks are going for round two, and seven riders from three nations will challenge the trek through the Greek backcountry. There is more to discover than just beaches, ancient ruins, Syrtaki and Souvlaki, alongside the old trails packed with history that reaches from the ancient world to the younger past. These are 1,000 kilometers of adventure spread on 5 days with trails far from daily routines on which we will stretch our limits, bite through and share unique experiences together. These are the Adventure Country Treks, Greece. Naftpaktos, at the entrance of the Corinthian Gulf, not far from Patras. This is a starting point for 5 days full of adventure. From here we will leave the daily life and enter 1,000 breathtaking kilometers of Greece.
Hello, I'm Dionysis. I'm working on the local dealer here in Greece for Touratech. It's my first time with you guys, and I'm very glad to have you here in Greece. You will find out that there is a very nice country with a big, great hospitality and great people. It's too beautiful, as you can see. And I hope you enjoy the trip with us.
Finally on the way after weeks of preparation and scouting, and everyone is curious about what Greece has to offer for this adventure, where we'll be going to discover a new site far away from the beaches and the ancient ruins. But first, we're heading out of Naftpaktos in direction Patras, and for the passage along the Strait of Andirio, we're choosing the old way by ferry. That doesn't only fit better to our rhythm, but also lets grow our anticipation, because the mountains which we will enter shortly are already in sight from here. Well, beforehand, 130 kilometers to go today, and some are still thinking that we will do it until lunchtime. A few kilometers on tarmac, and then the trek will shoot us from ground level up to an 1800 meter mountain pass.
Die Spannung nach dem ersten Anreisetag war natürlich hoch und jetzt am ersten Fahrtag, da klopft das Herz. Man ist quasi hin und her gerissen. Auf der einen Seite hat man diese Pfade hier durchs Gebirge. Man hat irgendwie Steine, man hat enge Stellen, man muss sich auf die Strecke konzentrieren. Und gleichzeitig geht einem das Herz auch wieder auf, dadurch, dass rechts und links diese wahnsinnigen Landschaften, der Blick runter nach Patras auf die Brücke und strahlend blauer Himmel darüber, es ist schon super geil. Weeks before at the scouting, things looked completely different here. Soaked ground, wind, rain and chilling temperatures drawing on our forces. Literally a mud fight we were facing before with GPS devices, bike and the Jeep. Sudden fog on 1700 meter altitude just before the last climb, and all this with single figure temperatures. Having left the comfort zone enough?
Yeah, but when we turn right here we will meet the track. Again.
No rain today, no fog. Yeah, completely different. You can see everything, and the floor is much better. Than the last days.
We could see the mountain that we are on now from our hotel that we started in the morning. And I was a little scary because the clouds were running over the mountain, but it's just beautiful here.
It's wonderful that we finally started after the rain yesterday. And although there were some clouds in the mountain, we just made it up to the mountain and the trek is just beautiful.
The views up here are just stunning, but you shouldn't be distracted too much from the trek, which is spiked with big stones falling down from the slopes.
C-Center riders, this is where we go to test our new products. Just to make sure that it's not failed doing your trip. Whoa!
We have left the view to the sea behind and are now diving into the breathtaking landscapes on the other side of the mountains. Smooth tracks are a real energy saver on this part, so we can regenerate a bit for the last few climbs of today. After a quick refreshment, we are heading up for a real highlight of today. Welcome to Adventure Riders Paradise. Welcome to the ACT Greece.
Das war ihr erster Tag. Also man denkt ja normalerweise Griechenland, das ist irgendwie Inselstrand, aber nein, hier der Peloponnes, das geht hoch bis auf 1800 Meter. Wir waren auf Anlagen von Windkraftanlagen da oben, wir sind über Felder gefahren, auf Hochebenen, hätte das nie erwartet, dass es sowas hier gibt. Und gleichzeitig gehen eigentlich natürlich auch bei so faszinierenden Gegenden andere Dinge durch den Kopf. Ja. Also ich hatte zum Beispiel vor 3 Monaten habe ich ein Buch gelesen, da ging es darum, dass genau in dieser Gegend hier eigentlich die griechischen Partisanen im Zweiten Weltkrieg mit der Wehrmacht gekämpft haben. Und wenn man sich das wiederum vorstellt und durch solche Landschaften und solche Erinnerungen auch fährt, dann verdichtet sich das natürlich in einen Fahrtag, der auf eine Art unvergleichlich ist.
Day one of the ACT Greece leads us on 130 kilometers from Naupaktos to Kalavrita, from ground level up to 1,800 meters. Depending on the weather, this trek can be extreme and is not meant for off-road beginners. So the best you can do is to take some friends with you for this 5-day adventure, because this was only the beginning. Day one offers 2 alternative routes on the last third of the trek. One leading from the small village Corphis to Kalavrita by paved roads, and another one with an exit from the off-road section on around 1,200 meter altitude. On both shortcuts, you will miss the highlight of the day riding along the edges of the grassy hills to the finish line. No matter which route you take, all of them meet together in the city of Kalavrita, with plenty of places to stay, gas for the bikes, and a well-deserved beer to cheer on this first day. If you want to add some more culture and history to your trip, then think about an extra day here in Kalavrita and visit the ancient Olympia, which is only about a 2-hour ride from here. Also about a 2-hour ride from our starting point in Naupaktos, you will find the ancient Delphi. The pictures of day one are still fresh, and we are curious about what day two of the ACT has to offer. Riders and bikes are ready for today's 260 km stage, starting alongside green valleys with a view on the mountains that we've crossed yesterday. The first off-road stage of today leads through well-known terrain. We are crossing yesterday's tracks and climbing above 1,300 meters, where our descent begins, down to the Strait of Andiriorgan, which we are going to cross by bridge today. We're passing Naupaktos again, where we've started yesterday. Time to fill up our supplies in the panniers and gas tanks one more time. Due to this will be the last time seeing the sea on our trip, we're stopping for an extended picnic break. On rocky tracks that were also playground of various Hellas rally stages, we're following Philippe, who has put this track together up on 1100 meter altitude. Endless gravel roads and pure riding pleasure is guaranteed if someone like him is looking for the best tracks around.
Nochmal hier vom Tag 2 von ACT Griechenland. Wie ihr da unten sehen könnt, türkisblaues Wasser erwarten euch hier in Griechenland. Geile Berge, tolle Schluchten, Canyons, Wälder, Felder, Olivenbäume und ich weiß nicht was alles. Super genial hier, das Fahren macht einfach mega Spaß. Shit.
So I'm sitting here on the course of trouble of today. The nice stone that I hit with my left pannier when I came out of the curve there. I tried to accelerate a bit and the left front corner of the pannier hit the stone. So I flew over to the right side and the bike fell over. So I bent a little bit the crash bar. I luckily just hit the ground with the hand and the helmet. So both the clothing is fine, the gloves are fine, and the helmet has some scratches, and the guys repaired the box so that we can put the pannier on and go on. Luckily nothing more happened, but honestly this is something that can happen on those trips if you are late in the day and you're getting a little bit tired. So the most important thing is really take care, go slow, take your time and be concentrated all the time, because the later it is, the more exhausted you will get and the more breaks you need to do. It's going to be a beautiful part here, and we still have a beautiful part ahead of us. But if you get distracted by anything, things like that can happen.
The shock is still in our minds, but luckily Martin and his bike are ready for today's upcoming 100 kilometers. We'll take care about the panniers later, and so we move on, and very soon the Mornu Reservoir in the middle of the mountains comes at sight. Even if this is a detour, we need to have a fuel stop here, because we'll not see any gas station until the end of day 3 in around 200 kilometers. In between, there's literally nothing, unless you can grab some liters from the locals somewhere in the mountains.
Ja, heute Tag 2. Ganz anderer Charakter als gestern. Gestern für mich ein gar nicht so leichter Einstieg, da ich wenig Offroad-Erfahrung habe. War ein ziemlich harter Einstieg für mich. Ich habe zwar alles soweit managen können, aber es war nicht so leicht für mich gestern, aber heute doch ganz andere Offroad-Passagen, wesentlich flüssiger, vom Speed auch ein bisschen schneller teilweise, ganz andere Technik, als mir als Straßenfahrer viel besser gelegen ist heute. Und vor allem, was mir besonders Spaß gemacht hat, jetzt am Ende der Tour gibt es auch wirklich wunderschöne Straßen hier. Natürlich mein Terrain, und auch da kann man wirklich die Landschaft und die Straßen super genießen.
Yes, we are here almost finishing second day of ACT Greece. A more relaxing day compared to yesterday. We faced immediately the challenges of ACT Greece yesterday. Today was more relaxing, more mixed. We had off-road, twisty roads, but also on-road with twisty roads. So regarding the difficulty level, ACT Greece is different from Portugal. It is targeted for medium and experienced riders. So, and if it is raining, it should be for expert riders. Nevertheless, if you are a beginner, don't prevent yourself from coming here. Just gather a group of other friends, come here and put yourself to the test. Because adventure is this, is getting out of your comfort zone and accomplishing something.
The clouds are running over and we need to hurry to arrive in the small village of Anohora in time, which is our today's finish point. Arriving here, we're fixing the panniers of Martin's Ducati first, and where metal is bent, a slight bit of violence can help. After the blows of the hammer fade away in the surrounding forests and after the panniers are mounted again, we will finish this day in absolute silence. Day 2 of the Adventure Country Tracks leads us from Calavrita to Anohora. On 260 kilometers, we have to face rocky off-road sections on the Peneplese before we crossing the Strait of Andirio again, leaving Navpaktos and the sea behind and enter the northern mountains. From now on, it's getting tight and so you should always carry enough gas and supplies with you. Refueling at the Mono Reservoir is mandatory because your gas should not only last for the 70 upcoming kilometers of today, but also for tomorrow's 130 kilometer trek, which will be demanding for the bikes in the off-road sections. Those who finish day 2 can be lucky to visit the small village of Anohora, where you can't find many, but some good places to stay. And if you can still see some lights in one of the small taverns, just go inside and taste the local food. Waking up in Anohora and taking a look outside the window, you will find yourself surrounded by endless forests. It's still early in the morning and the sun is just about hitting the mountain peaks around when we are preparing for the next stage. The track is like a roller coaster ride and it will be a pain to move forward in the deep forests. But that's exactly what we're here for, and with the first sun rays we're entering the track of day 3. Those who need a little wake up after the first 30 kilometers should make a stop in the small village Elatovrisi and order a Greek coffee from Antonio. It's unlikely that you'll meet other people here because most of them moved out in the cities.
It's a nice place here. It's a nice village in the middle of the forested mountains, and I think it's a great place to stop. Probably I open a coffee here myself, because probably once a week there is somebody coming through, so you'll have a pretty relaxed life here. People are like this, and it's cool. It's a nice place.
Das ist der dritte Tag heute und es ist heute Morgen ging es etwas kühl los, aber inzwischen ist die Sonne voll rausgekommen. Wir sind die ganze Zeit durch Wälder gefahren, Pinien, Nadelwälder, so richtig boreale um 900 Meter, verschiedene Arten. Und die Wege, die wir gefahren sind, waren spitze. Schön ist natürlich, dass hier in Griechenland jede Straße, jeder Waldweg zu fahren ist. Und dass es nicht von der Provinzregierung oder lokalen Regierung abhängt, sondern man kann landesweit diese Waldwege fahren. Für Offroader ist es natürlich ein Paradies hier.
Not far from our coffee break, teamwork is needed. Obviously, there aren't many vehicles passing by here, and so it can get really slippery. Everyone is helping out getting the bikes across the stone-packed creek safely, because if something breaks in this area, you will have a long walk to find the next road. There isn't much time to relax, because the track is really challenging in some sections, and that's why today's 130 km can stretch out over some hours more or less, depending on the conditions. But the struggles of the first half will pay off with these views that are still to come today. We will climb to almost 1,700 meters with a breathtaking scenery comparable to the end of day one.
What an awesome stone crossing here, the stone challenge of day three.
This is Adventure Country Tracks, adventure.
After a quick refueling, we're passing by our initial finish of today in Karpenisi. Because, to be honest, our mind is more about campfire and canned beers today. And for that, we're more than motivated to do some extra 30 kilometers.
You left me in summertime. No cold, no goodbye. So I flew a thousand miles just to see again, again your eyes. And I don't know why you're still and you're still on my mind. I don't know why you're still and you're still on my mind. I don't know why you're still and you're still on my mind. You're still and you're still on my mind. Had so many things to tell you. Wish I can walk with you like the first time I met you. Now I wander around, I wander around.
Nice.
Losing you, losing sleep, losing all my.
Spectacular day. We started in the mountains and we started on some tar and then directly went into the dirt, and the dirt this today had a nice little flow. It was going mainly through forest roads. Some of them have been washed out and we had some really tricky parts, especially where the riverbeds came down. We had to really push the bikes through or try to make it together. We had some water crossings and some of the parts were quite tricky, so we helped each other. So I would recommend, if you go here, just don't go by yourself, don't go alone, have a company with you so that you can help each other on the tricky parts, because sometimes when it rains here the road is washed out a bit and it's pretty tricky to go through. But beside this, it's perfect.
Legend says that in Greece, the soldiers of the Olympo, they become rocks and they are in the middle of the tracks and they move around to capture the travelers and make them slaves.
Yamas!
Yamas!
Did you see the two donkeys today?
No, I see a horse.
No.
Day 3 of the Adventure Country Tracks in Greece leads us on lonely trails from Anochora through the southern Agrafa mountains to the small city of Karpenissi. It's 130 kilometers where you can get an impression of how shattered and inaccessible some areas of Europe can be. Small villages like Elatovrisi are telling the story about the rural exodus of the population, because most of the year it only has around a dozen inhabitants. On the challenging trek through the mountains and forests, you should take care of yourself, because it's obvious what heavy rain can do with the trails. Also, gas stations can't be found around here, and if you're running out of daylight, there's nothing but to camp or find a place to sleep in one of the small villages. We've reached the middle of the Adventure Country Tracks in Greece, and also because of that, you should take some time for this day. Time to open yourself for the impressions around. Thank you. Actually, the impressions from yesterday are moments that we want to keep forever. And that's why the start into day 4 was a bit wistful. Perceived our journey has just begun now, and basically it is that exact feeling that we were looking for so long. Detached from our daily life, being in the here and now on the bike.
Cold in the morning, but okay, it was nice. I'm looking forward to see today's places.
This place is amazing. Yeah, it was perfect.
Guten Morgen, hier aus Griechenland, Act Tag 4. Nach einer echt atemberaubenden Nacht in einem ausgetrockneten oder halb ausgetrockneten Flussbelt im Zelt geht es dann heute Morgen direkt wieder weiter auf Etappe Nummer 4, ungefähr 120, 130 Kilometer mit dem üblich hohen Offroad-Anteil. Ja, die ganze Eckgeschichte hier hat ungefähr 70-80% Offroad-Anteil, aber auch die Landstraßen, die zwischendurch hier sind sehr geil zu fahren. Immer wieder ein sehr überraschender Asphalt, dann mal wieder kein Asphalt. Wo man auf jeden Fall immer ein Auge drauf haben muss, sind dicke Felsbrocken, die echt überall rumliegen und überall runterkommen.
Look, today's and yesterday's, it's my favorite terrain. I don't mind if it's rocky or muddy, but from the side of the view and the landscape, the yesterday's and today's, it's amazing.
It doesn't take a long time until we're getting caught up by the present. We're having the feeling of being really inside now, and we're winding along the well-prepared tracks following the shape of the terrain. Deep canyons and valleys are unfolding in front of us, and if we already had the feeling of being in the wilderness yesterday, today it is the real thing. Already during the first scouting in October 2016, we found out at this exact place that theories on the map and actual rideable trails have nothing in common. So there's nothing left but adjusting the route to the shape of the mountains.
faced this terrific scenario. It seems the road was blocked. No, it's not. It's still, but it will not.
After the track is opened again, we're heading in the direction of Agrafa. If this divine gravel road will be replaced by tarmac soon? A small restaurant deep down in the valley is not only a rare but also a good opportunity for a lunch break on the track. We are passing Agrafa, and not far from here we are entering a landscape that will cut your breath.
Was eine geile Piste. Da muss man gar nicht weit wegreisen. Muss man nicht schön nach Utah oder sonst wohin nach Übersee? Quasi direkt vor der Haustür hier in Griechenland.
That's nothing for people being afraid of height. On the edge of the steep serpentines, it goes up to the last climb of today with over more than 1,600 meter altitude. The view from up here is just stunning.
Here you get the impression you're kind of like on the top of the world. I mean, the road here is, the road itself is quite smooth, but you're always on the edge of the cliff and it goes down about 500 meters, but you have to do this. I mean, if you're having a 360 degrees view like this, this is probably not only the highlight of the day, it's probably the highlight of the trip.
Ja, Tag 4 heute und es hört einfach nicht auf, super schön zu sein. Landschaft ist überwältigend, wirklich. Ich hätte es nie erwartet von Griechenland. Es ist ständig neu, es wechselt dauernd die Landschaft. Wir sind ja wieder auf 1650 oben und es ist einfach ein Traum. Ich habe voll Spaß dabei und auch mit der V-Strom Offroad früher nie so gemacht, aber ich bin sicher, das war ganz auf jeden Fall nicht meine letzte Offroad-Tour. Geil.
From this point ongoing, we are facing the descent into the valley. Our goal for today? Neo Hori at the Plastira Reservoir. What an amazing view at the end of day 4 that we are enjoying while having fresh Greek food. Day 4 did not start in Karpenisi as planned, but already 30 kilometers further on the track at the old bridge, where we spent the night in our tents. So initially this day has a 150 kilometer track to offer, leading over high mountains and through deep valleys. The landscapes around are nothing less than spectacular. You will be lost searching for alternative routes up here, and so you need to adapt to the conditions and, in the worst case, wait until the roads are open again. There's not much room for larger scaled explorations around the original track, as you'll almost certainly will be running out of fuel. who didn't refuel at the starting point in Karpenisi will have to suck the last drop out of the gas tank. The next refueling point will be close to the finish of this day near Neohori. For the fifth and last day, you should regenerate well, because tomorrow there will be a long stage ahead.
Eck Griechenland, das ist jetzt schon das zweite Mal, dass wir dabei sein dürfen. Und für mich ist Griechenland noch mal ein Stück weit geiler als Portugal. Beides ist sehr, sehr schön, aber Griechenland, ja, das fordert mich doch einiges mehr, weil die Tracks doch ein wenig härter sind als in Portugal. Und ich habe hier echt einen Riesenspaß. Und ja, für uns ist das Projekt aus mehreren Gründen sehr wichtig. Zum einen natürlich ist es wichtig, dass wir diese ganze Offroad-Geschichte in Europa einfach ein bisschen fördern können. Wir haben nicht viele Möglichkeiten, Offroad zu fahren in Europa. Und ich denke, dass das einfach eine coole Aktion ist, dass jedermann einfach Tracks finden kann, relativ einfach, die gut beschrieben sind, und dann sich ja, aufs Moped setzen kann und losfahren kann. Zum anderen nutzen wir aber auch die Möglichkeit, hier neue Produkte und auch bestehende Produkte nochmal wirklich zu testen unter härtesten Bedingungen. Sowohl in der Kommunikation in der Gruppe beim Fahren, wie auch in der Kommunikation mit dem Filmteam. Zudem kommt, dass auch die Gruppe hier in Griechenland, jetzt besonders hier in Griechenland, ist einfach eine geile Gruppe. Wir haben extrem viel Spaß. Auch in den anstrengenden Momenten halten wir zusammen, helfen uns gegenseitig, wenn jemand stürzt oder wenn steinige Passagen kommen, wo man einfach alleine nicht weiterkommt. Geht halt nicht immer alleine. Don't be the hero. Für mich ist das einfach eine super Aktion und ich freue mich, dass ich hier sein darf.
For the finals of a unique trip, there are 250 more breathtaking kilometers unveiling. Today we are facing a mix of steep gravel tracks and endless curves on tarmac. We're saying goodbye to the Plastira Lake and are taking a tough start into this stage with S-canning on 1750 meter. Luckily, with some good weather, because also here a little bit of rain is enough to transform the trail into a mud fight.
Time to
Above the small village of Pyra, we found this small chapel right beside the road. Dionysus tells us that there are plenty of those around in the mountains also allowed to being used as shelter for night. So the doors are open and we can have a look inside. Still around 2/3 of the track to go, and so we need to open the throttles of our bikes. Metsovo is the biggest and last city we are crossing today before we are leaving the mountains behind. On our way to the finish, there's one curve followed by the next, and by this, even the fun on paved roads is guaranteed here in Greece. On the late afternoon, we are finally reaching Monodendri, only a few kilometers away from the finish line of the adventure country tracks in Greece. The tension is real on the last stretch because for the end there's something really unique waiting for us.
Kind of speechless. I mean, this is. I've seen the Kolka Canyon, I've seen the Grand Canyon, Bryce, Zion, whatever, but that we have that here in Europe is spectacular.
This is.
So, we are finally here at the end of the second adventure country treks this year here in Greece. The word that comes to my mind is intense. It has been 5 days of intense adventure, intense riding, intense friendship. It really gives me a sense of accomplishment to have this group of guys riding together and reaching the end of the track here in Greece.
Was ein sensationeller Abschluss von ACT Griechenland. Der ganze Trip war wirklich von Tag zu Tag einfach nur genial. Jeden Tag was Neues erlebt.
Ich bin weniger Erwartungen hergekommen, weil ich einfach grundsätzlich ein Mensch bin, der offen ist für alles und entdeckt und für Abenteuer immer zu haben ist. Und ich bin sehr beeindruckt von diesen 5 Tagen, die ich hier erlebt habe, in einer tollen Gruppe mit wirklich wundervollen Menschen. Und jeder Tag aufs Neue ein Abenteuer, steigert sich so weiter. Nicht nur, also Offroad habe ich mir grundsätzlich anfangs etwas schwer getan, nicht ganz meine Welt gewesen, aber ich habe mich gut reingefunden. Am zweiten Tag lief es richtig gut gab auch einige Straßenanteile, aber neben den Menschen, mit denen ich sehr viel Spaß und eine gute Zeit hatte, auch diese Abwechslung auf der Tour hier war wirklich ganz, ganz toll. Und gerade auch, wie man hier sieht, man erwartet sowas nicht in Europa. Griechenland ist ein ganz tolles Land und ACT in dem Rahmen für mich war ein ganz besonderes Erlebnis.
Elvio said before it was intense. Yes, it was 5 days full of intense, and I agree with that. And today was my favorite day because we came here in Vicos Canyon, and it's my first time here. I've never been here before, and I'm very glad that I came here with you guys.
Well, after the Portuguese ACT, here it's completely different. The language. Everything is new. It was my first time in Greece, and yeah, now the projects are complete, and I'm really, really happy because people now can have a very great adventure here in Greece.
Ich selber bin ja schon relativ lange jetzt mit dem Motorrad unterwegs, also habe mit 14 quasi in der Kiesgrube Offroad angefangen und habe schon viele vergleichbare Touren in Regionen gemacht, aber Griechenland ist schon was Besonderes, weil diese Berge auf der einen Seite, die Gebirgsdörfer und gleichzeitig aber auch die Art und Weise, wie die Leute auf einem zugehen, wenn man sich ein bisschen öffnet hier, das ist schon sehr außergewöhnlich und ich würde sagen, Griechenland-Tour, das ist schon einzigartig.
It was just so, so wonderful. And the last 5 days that we spent together was something that you do not forget. And for me, this is what the Adventure Country Treks is all about, that you have maybe not the trip of a lifetime, but a little glimpse of it, what you want to do for the rest of your life if you want to retire. Here in Greece, you can do that within 5 days, plus 1-2 days arriving and going home again. But it's easy to go, and what we see here, especially the canyon here in the end, you don't have to go around the world to see how beautiful the landscape is. Greece is just a wonderful country to go.
What an amazing finish of the last 250 kilometers today. From Neohori we went through the mountains along endless valleys and curves to the 1000 meters deep Vicos Canyon. Impressions and memories that we will take home. Impressions and memories of the second Adventure Country Treks here in Greece.
To me.